Hello and welcome to today's video. Today we'll be discussing some numericals in ship stability, specifically in the topic listing of ships, lifting of mass on board a ship, and squat. These are the three topics which we'll be talking about. So let me start with the first question. We have a ship whose displacement is 5100 tons. The center of gravity kg is given to be 4 meters, and km is given to be at 4.8 meters. A double bottom tank on the starboard side is 20 meters long, 6 meters wide, and 1 meter deep, which is full of fresh water. We need to calculate the list which will be developed on this vessel if 60 tons of water from this tank has been consumed. So if I can draw a diagram, a transverse view of the vessel, so this will be somewhere my central line. So as per the question given, there is a DB tank here. This tank, as the dimensions are given, is 20 meters long across the length of the vessel. And it is 6 meters wide if we take the width of the tank, and 1 meter deep if we take the height of the tank. And this tank is full of water, fresh water. That is what is given in the question. And what is given is we have 60 tons of water has been consumed from this tank. And we are supposed to find out the resulting list. So this is what is asked in the question. And from this figure, I hope you have understood the question with the help of this figure. So we need to divide the answer into two parts. One is movement of mass in the vertical plane and movement of mass in the horizontal plane. So first, if I take the formula for movement of mass in the vertical plane, the shifting in center of gravity, GGV, can be found out by W into D by W minus W, where small W is the mass which has moved, capital W is the displacement, mass displacement of the vessel, and D is actually the distance between center of gravity of the ship and center of gravity of the tank, or the location from which the mass has been removed. That is D. So people always get make mistakes in this calculation of D here. So it is clearly given in the question, the center of gravity of the ship is at 4 meters, and the center of gravity of the tank we can take as 0.5 meters, which is from the keel. The double bottom tank always starts from the keel. So from the keel, the tank is 1 meters high. So half of that is 0.5. That is how 0.5 has been taken. So this calculation gives 0.0417 meters. So the initial kg is given to be 4. The vertical shift in center of gravity is 0.0417. Which means the final kg should be 3.95835. If I subtract these two values, so once I know the final kg, I can find out km. Okay, km is given to be 4.8 meters from the question. So the final kg we have calculated. So km minus kg is gm. So this will be the final gm value. Let it be as it is. Now let us calculate the movement of center of gravity in the horizontal plane. So if I take the horizontal plane goes like this. The same formula, again the formula is same, but only the way I calculate D will be different here. So somewhat W is the weight mode, which is 60, same as our previous calculation. Capital W is the mass displacement of the vessel. See, we have to take the same mass in both these cases. The W's will be same here. And D is the distance in the horizontal plane between the center of gravity of the ship and center of gravity of the tank. Now please look at this. The width of the tank is given as 6 meters. We can see from the central line it is 6 meters. Now they have not mentioned specifically anything about the location of the double bottom tank. The only assumption in this question which we are making is the double bottom tank, which is said to be in starboard side as per the question. So only the assumption which we will take is the double bottom tank will start from our central line. It will start from the central line and run towards your starboard end. This is one assumption we will take in the answer. Now, you can argue, because this is not a point specifically mentioned in the question. Like, I can also have a tank, you know, you can ask always, like, why don't we have a tank which actually starts from this point and runs like this. Okay, so that is also true, but this is one assumption we will take, that double bottom tank starts from your central line, bottom will be your keel, and you'll be running towards your starboard side. So if I take that assumption, the center of gravity of this tank will be at half of this width, which will be 3 meters. So that is why 3 meters is the distance from center of gravity of the vessel, which is at the central line, and center of gravity of the tank, which is at 3 meters. So this distance is 3. So GGH I'll get as 0.03571 meter. And if you take the formula for list, the formula for list is GGH by Vm final. This is the formula for list. So if I substitute our the GGH value which I got now and the final GM value which we got earlier, if I substitute, I'll get this value. So tan theta is this value, which means theta I'll get as 2.429 degree. Now remember, we have a situation where mass has been consumed from your starboard side. So when we have a removal of mass from starboard side, we have a situation where more mass is there. Effectively, we have more mass in the port side. So that is why this list will be towards your port side. That is why the final answer, it is important that we have to specify where the list has been developed. So I hope the question number one, which we have discussed now, is explanatory, as is well understood by you. Now, the only assumption, as I told you, is that the double bottom tank we will take starting from the central line towards your starboard end, which is specifically written as DB tank on starboard side. So that is why I assume it starts from central line, run towards your starboard side. The length in longitudinal direction 20, width is 6, and the height is 1 meter. So this is one way I take this question. Now, again, if you have any doubts or any corrections, anything you want to ask me, please always email me back at promote.imu@gmail.com. Hope this question has been well understood. Thank you.